Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm actually gonna share with you the polishes that I purchased in March of 2023. I have been so good about not purchasing anything since December of 2022. Honestly, I've been really good about not purchasing anything since November of 2022 because that's the last time I purchased things. So yeah, that counts. But this month I did fall off the horse or the wagon or whatever you want to call it and actually ended up purchasing some things, and I'm gonna share those with you today. Before we get started, I do want to share with you all today the polish that I'm wearing on my fingers right now. This is Great Lakes Lacquer, and this is Love Wins, and I've had this in my collection for quite some time. I do believe I was gifted this, but I cannot quite recall. It's a beautiful polish though, very lovely, and I did some springtime stamping. And I like it. I changed the background up a little bit to be on theme with the month of March, because the month of March I wore mostly all greens, but this is a really, like, it's almost like a foresty green on camera for some reason. One of the first things that I bought this month is a couple of brushes from e.l.f. These are the concealer brushes, and I buy these for my cleanup. This is the brush that I prefer to use. I have purchased recommendations from other YouTubers of cleanup brushes that they like, and I always go back to this one. I couldn't find this at my local Target. It used to be sold at Kohl's, but no, Kohl's no longer has e.l.f. products. They have a Sephora beauty area, and so of course I can't find them at Kohl's. They were sold out at Target, and they were also sold out online. And then my friend, who lives about 45 minutes away from me, had checked her Target, and they actually had some at her Target. So she bought me three, and then I got a notification. They did request a notification for the brushes when they were back online, and I did get a notification saying that they were back online. So I ended up purchasing my extra e.l.f. brushes. So right now I have a total of 9 brushes total that I have not used. I do like having backup of these because they do sell out multiple times. Every time I go to buy one, if I'm like really running out, they are always sold out, and I just like to get at least like 10 to have with me because I know it's going to be a couple of months before I order them again. To me, they last a decent amount of time considering that they're not meant to be used with acetone. I think I can get 3 to 4 months use of mine longer if I am careful about moisturizing the brush after I use it. And but yeah, for the most part, I just really enjoy this brush the best for my personal style of cleanup, I guess. So this month, I bought a couple of spring things from Essie. This first Essie is called Bon Boy-age, and this is actually inspired by... This polish was actually inspired by Tori's Nails here on YouTube. She was wearing this in one of her videos, and I just could not stop staring at her fingers, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is so lovely. I love that polish. And I was really lucky because I found this at my local Marshalls. Very rarely do I find Essies that I'm interested in my Marshall or TJ Maxx. I generally buy my Essies online. Very rarely will I find something at my local store, like brick and mortar store, to purchase from them. And to have this one, because I think this is a pretty older Essie, if I remember correctly, and it has a little bit of ugly bottle syndrome right here, but honestly, a good shake, I think it'll work wonders. This is like such a pretty sagey kind of green. I don't know, it just looks lovely, and I'm still very attracted to greens, especially in the spring. So when I saw it, I knew I had to get it because I was obsessed at looking at her nails in her video. Another polish that I've purchased at my local Marshalls, and this is Essie Slip Dress. Oh my gosh, was it a pain in the butt to remove that sticker, the stickiness. I'm trying to be better about removing the stickers since I do show bottle shots, but this is a polish that I normally don't gravitate towards, but for the price, I was like, why not? It's just, it looks like it's a sheer pink, like kind of like one of those super super sheer pinks. Looking for something that would give me almost like negative space because I'm kind of interested in trying that nail art form out, so we'll see. I've never tried like a negative space kind of look, and I'm interested in doing it, but I don't like the look of just the bare nails. I want a hint of color, and this is really sheer. I mean, you can tell it's really sheer. I don't know how it's gonna look on me, but I'm gonna give it a whirl, see how I like it. I mean, if anything, this could be just my I don't know. It's just, I think it'll
and
work
then,
out.
And then from the new Essie Spring Collection, I did purchase this one. This is called Ride the Soundwave. Actually, I don't know if this is from the new Spring Collection or from the pre-Spring Collection. This collection has been out since, I want to say January. And at first when I saw them, I was thinking, first of all, if you've watched me before, you know that spring is my least favorite nail polish season. I'm just not a big spring person. I saw this collection come out, and the first thought was, oh my God, it's just the spring collection. I have those colors. I don't need them. I saw this collection, this entire collection in person at Ulta around January when they first came out, and I was not impressed, not even a little bit. I don't know what it was, but it was just kind of like, meh, whatever. And then I started noticing these colors on different skin tones on my feed, and all of a sudden I had this urge, this need to get these polishes. Now, I did not get the entire collection. I purchased two, and this Ride a Soundwave is one of them. My justification for buying this are, well, multi-layered. I was having a really, really crappy day, like severely crappy. It was insane how crappy my day or my week has been at the time that I purchased this. And another thing was, I didn't want to feel the same regrets that I felt for Bleu La La, which was a spring blue that I was attracted to, but then I was just like, I have something like it, I don't need it, blah, blah, blah. And then years later, I was hunting for it everywhere, and I finally got it last year, so yay to that. But the point is, I didn't want to go hunting for something that I could easily buy now. So I was in Walgreens, and oh, look, there's like a little, is that like a dark pigmentation, or is that a ball? I'm not sure. That was weird. Anyways, regardless, I was at Walgreens, I saw the collection there, I grabbed this polish, I have no regrets. The next color from the same collection is Your Sensational. And of course I had to get this chartreusey, lime greeny yellow color. It's very reminiscent of Chelato. However, I know they're not dupes. I already investigated that, and they don't look like dupes, but they're close enough, and this one seems to have a better formula that I was willing to get it. Like, I was willing to like put my money where my mouth is and get this one and check it out. So this is, yeah, I had to get this one. So these two are the only polishes that I got from that collection so far. I am seriously tempted to get the other two colors, not the topper. The topper does not interest me at all, but I'm seriously tempted to get the other two colors, but I'm trying to like pace myself here. Next Essie is from an order that I placed from Beyond Polish, and this is Essie Gel Couture in Atlier the Bay. Atelier? I don't know. I may be saying that all wrong. This is a polish that I was actually inspired to purchase because of Laurie from Gold Polished. I watched her videos for her favorite spring polishes of 2022. I usually do around the springtime because since spring is not my favorite season, I feel like I need a little inspiration or a little push to get me to want to wear those spring polishes or the spring colors. And so I end up rewatching like favorite spring videos. She's not the only one that I watch, but she's the one that inspired me to pull out some of my old favorites or pull out similar colors. She had this polish in her collection, and I was interested in it last year when I saw the video the first time, and I was just like, I'm not gonna get it. I have pale yellows, blah, 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 blah. But I got it. I got it. Oh, I was, I just couldn't help myself, and it was just calling to me, and I decided to get it just because why not? I wanted it for a year. I still wanted it. I got it. I did want to do a callback on the duo from the new Essie Spring Collection. I was having conversations with my nail polish friends, happy day I had, and how I was thinking about getting these polishes, and then I didn't get the polishes. And then I felt like that meme where they say, girl, don't do it, you don't need it. And then the other girl's like, I don't need it, I'm not gonna do it. And then later on, she's like, I did it. That was me with these two polishes. That was me with these two polishes. I just was like, I'm not gonna get them, but they are attractive and blah, 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 blah. And I just kept going back and forth and back and forth. And then I ended up purchasing it. That I wanted to share that because I thought it was really funny when I was having those conversations. Back to the Beyond Polish order. I also purchased this Essie from Beyond Polish, I just said, Tropic Low. And this was inspired by Polish _by the Dozen. She wore this earlier in the month of March, and I was just obsessed. Like, I just kept staring at her post with this polish, and I was just like, I need to get this polish. How did I not? I don't remember this polish. When did this come out? I haven't researched this. At the time that I'm recording this video, I have not researched when this polish came out, but I have no recollection of seeing this polish ever. Like, I do not recall this polish at all. And I can't believe it. Like, I can't believe that I don't remember it. I can't believe that I didn't buy it when I saw it the first time. What was I thinking? I don't know. But I love it. My daughter has already used this. She already put it on her nail, or she asked me to put it on her nails for her. And she ended up loving it. She was like, my nails are green. It was so cute because when I unboxed the package, she was over here and she's like, ooh, mommy, what's that? And it was just the cutest thing ever. I also wanted to purchase this because I was having major FOMO because I did not get Sweet and Sour Lacquer, What Are You Doing in My Swamp from February Polish Pickup, because I have not purchased Polish Pickup in such a long time. And I was trying to be good, and now I have deep FOMOs. And so when I saw this, it was giving me the same vibe. And I was like, this is accessible to me. I can purchase it. And also from the Beyond Polish order, I have Orly's in Blue Iris. This was from spring of last year, or was it the year before? I can't remember, but I know that this has been on my mind for quite some time. And I didn't purchase it before because, again, spring, I don't know. I just have a thing about buying spring polishes because I feel like I have too many of the similar that are similar. And yet there are some polishes that like nag at me. Like they just, you know, they stay in my head. And when I saw it and I was going to place an order for Beyond Polish for the other polishes that I have here, I was just like, why not? Just do it. Just do it. And I did. And I have no regrets. I'm sure I have something similar to it. I'm sure I can dupe it. I still have no regrets. I really love this color. It looks beautiful. Another one that I really, really wanted to get and didn't get for the same reason as I discussed in Blue Iris. It was just, it's a spring collection. Even though the color always attracted me, I just never got it. I never got it. And I had regrets. And again, I was going to place an order for basic polishes, so I decided to get it. I want to do a quick comparison because this is one of the reasons why I didn't get this one. This here is China Glaze in Show 'Em Who's Blossom, and I had this and I didn't feel that I needed this Orly in Artist Garden because I felt like they were going to be similar or comparable, and obviously they are not that similar as I thought, so even more of a reason to be happy that I got this Orly. And since we're here already, I want to do a quick comparison of Bon Boy-age. And these look a lot more similar than Artist Garden from Orly, but they're still not exactly the same. Obviously, they're close enough that I really honestly don't need both, but I have already worn this one twice and I really enjoy how it looks on me. So I'm gonna keep both of them because I really want to wear this one. It's lighter, a little bit, a touch grayer or maybe blue leaning than what is this called? Show 'Em Who's Blossom, the China Glaze. So similar enough that I probably don't need both, but I'm going to keep both. And then I was lucky enough to put an ISO out for Sweet and Sour Lacquer in What Are You Doing in My Swamp. And while I didn't get the giant bottle, I did get this little mini 5 milliliter decant of the polish from a fellow polish lover from the Facebook group, and I really appreciate it. I haven't worn this one yet. I'm gonna wear it and see if I love it. If I love it and I can get a full size bottle later on, I'll probably purchase a full size bottle, but I feel like this is just enough for me to kind of like curb that thing that makes me crave this polish. I have it so I can use it and then be happy and content with my use. And also makes me realize that these are not as similar as I thought they were. They give the same vibe, so it's not like I needed this, but I'm glad I was able to have this little 5 milliliter one in my collection because I'll get to use what I want, and if I want some more, hopefully it comes back in Rewind. If not, I can find it in a destash in the future if I really feel like I need a big bottle, but this is just enough. And then in March, I think it was March, I placed an order for Wildflower Lacquer. She had come out with her new collection, which was the Back to the 90s Volume 1, and I purchased Juice
bar.
So this polish is one that immediately attracted me because, of course, it is a shimmery polish with the gold shimmer and hollow flakes. I absolutely love this finish. Sorry if you all can hear my kids in the background. They're just having fun today. And so Juice Bar is, I don't know, it's one of the few from the collection that I really, really was interested in. The collection was beautiful, just I felt like I had similarities to what was already on there, and I'm attracted to this bright, like, this bright pink for spring this year. It's really calling to me, so of course I had
it. And the other polish that I bought from that collection was Dolphin Obsession, because I too was obsessed with dolphins in the 90s.
I wanted to be a marine biologist because I wanted to work with dolphins. And to this day, I am in my 40s, and to this day, I cry when I see a dolphin in real life. I kid you not. We went to SeaWorld last year in Texas, and I saw the dolphins, like the dolphin show, and I was just like silently crying, and my husband was like, "What's wrong with you?" And I'm like, "They're so beautiful." I can't help it. It's like, they're so beautiful. They're so majestic. I love them. When I see them in person, it triggers me every time. So anyways, I had to get this polish. And not only that, but it's freaking beautiful. Look at that. Look at that beauty. I mean, how could I not get this polish? But yeah, it was just a must-have for me. Now, this is not a polish this is not a topper that I purchased. This is a replacement topper from Polish Pickup, because I had purchased a Apipila smudge-free top coat from Polish Pickup last year or the year before. I can't remember when it was. And I don't use it as often because I have another bottle that I use more, but I couldn't find that other bottle because my daughter likes to play around in my room, and sometimes she moves things, and I couldn't find it. So I was like, oh, I'll just use the one that I have from Polish Pickup. And I noticed that the one that I had has, I can't find it again. I wanted to show you guys the bottle. I can't find it again, but basically it had some metal, like rust dust, like dust from the rust from the bar. I don't know how to explain it, but it had some rust in it, and I had to remember seeing a post about it, and I was just like, oh yeah. I mean, when I first saw it, I was like, I think mine does that, is doing that, but I didn't feel it was that bad, or like, anyways, the point is that when I went to use my bottle again, it was bad, and I was just like, oh, I don't want to use this. So I took some pictures and I sent it to Polish Pickup, and they were real quick, real friendly to send me a new bottle, and I'm so happy because I love this top coat.
The next couple of polishes, including this one, are polishes that I got from a swap from Jackie, from Nurse Jackie here on YouTube, and this is Bee's Knees Lacquer in I Love Pizza So Much.
I did not get this polish. This was part of the mystery polish, I think, and when I saw it, I fell in love with it, and she was willing to swap it with me, and I'm very happy with that swap because this is beautiful.
She was also kind enough to send me this top coat from Sally Hansen, because when this it was a trio of top coats from Sally Hansen, when they came out, I couldn't find them anywhere. Again, I have such a hard time finding like limited edition or new collection products in my area. It's such a hassle, and I couldn't find these. I actually don't remember how we got into the conversation, but she ended up saying that if she saw it at her local store, that she'd get it for me, and I was like, yay, this is great. And so she got it for me, and now I have it too.
She also sent me a little bottle of Sir Colors Crushed Ice. She decanted this from her bottle, and I really appreciate it. This is a product that I have not used, but she has raved about this product, and I really wanted to use it, and I'm so thankful that she sent me this cute little bottle of it. And then my favorite of everything that we have swapped. I loved everything, but this is like the coup de grace. Is that how you say it? Because that's how I'm saying it. This is a Never Naked by Jackie, and this is called That's What Friends Are For. This is inspired by a glam polish that I missed out on way back in, what, 2019, 2018? I can't even remember. I've been on the hunt for that polish, and I cannot find it anywhere. And it's a curly polish with like hot pink glitters and gold glitters and little micro glitters. It was limited edition. It was for Valentine's Day, I think it was. And what kills me about that polish is that I was on the site when it opened, ready to buy this polish, and I talked myself out of it because I was trying to be good. And literally like 4 hours later, I went to go buy it, and it was sold out. Like, it was done.
I was so upset with myself. Like, and I have been upset with myself, and I haven't been able to find that polish, and I haven't been able to find a dupe. I thought I did with Emily DeMolly. I thought I did with another brand that I can't remember, and they were just not the same. This is so pretty. This is so perfect. Very, very close to the dead-on dupe that I'm looking for. Regardless, it's so much brighter than the other ones that I was trying to use to dupe it, and I freaking love it. And I thank you, Jackie, so much for taking the time to make this custom polish for me. I appreciate your friendship, and I appreciate this, and it's just like win-win-win. I'm so happy. I don't want to start gushing a lot on the video, but I'm very, very happy that I have this, and this is most definitely going on to my spring rack, and if I don't get to wear it during the springtime, I'm definitely wearing it in the summer. I forgot two more polishes that I purchased in the month of March. This is China Glaze in Here for the Candy. This is part of their new collection for spring. Now, I did purchase this through Polish Pick, and when I got the polish, it was slightly open. So this one I am trying to work with because the formula was a little bit thicker and a little bit almost goopy, but not really, not quite. And so I am trying to work with this, or maybe I need to find a new one. I'm undecided on what I'm gonna do with this, but this is one of the polishes from that collection that I had to have. Like, just this color just calls to me, and I love light pinks, and it looked like it had a good formula. It looks so pretty on everybody I've seen it on, so I had to get this one. And then the next one is China Glaze in Gimme, Suga. And I really wanted to have this because I don't have Flip Flop Fantasy, the original. I don't have the new one because I don't like that color as much. And I am attracted to this kind of color a little bit more. And it is bright and it is beautiful. And I'm just feeling it. I'm feeling this color. So I had to purchase it. And I bought both of these from Polish Pick. All right, everyone, that is it. Those are all the polishes that I purchased for the month of March. It hasn't been a lot compared to my usual purchases, so I'm very proud of myself for that fact. But still, they're probably polishes that I really, 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 really should not have purchased, but I did. And I have no regrets. They made me happy, and it's my collection, and I do with it what I want to, right? I mean, that's how it works. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know down in the comments if you have any of the polishes that I purchased for the month of March. And if you do, is it your favorite? Is it one that you really love? Or if you have something that's similar, let me know in the comments down below. Thank you, everyone, so much for taking time out of your day to watch this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.